So why did the Obama administration today abstain from voting on the United Nations Security Council resolution condemning Israeli settlements in the West Bank and East Jerusalem? We asked Ben Rhodes, Deputy National Security Advisor for Strategic Communications to the President. Ben Rhodes, welcome. It is the case that the U.S. has long opposed these Israeli settlements, but at the same time, it has protected Israel and the U.N. against these condemning resolutions. Why the shift?
Well, look, first of all, it's bipartisan tradition to oppose settlements, as you mentioned. There have been many resolutions in the past under bipartisan administrations that address the Arab-Israeli conflict. The fact of the matter is we vetoed a resolution that addressed settlements in 2011, and look what's happened since. We've had failed peace process after failed peace process, and the pace of settlement construction has accelerated significantly. And just recently, you had the Israeli prime minister saying that this is the most pro-settlement administration in Israeli history, the Israeli government that is currently in place. We believe that at this pace, a two-state solution could be put at risk. We believe that would be profoundly bad for Israel and its security. And so that's why the president took the decision that he did.
It comes across, Ben Rhodes, though, as a parting shot at Israel on the part of President Obama.
Well, look, we have a record that we'll put up next to anybody in terms of support for Israel. In fact, we just concluded a $38 billion 10-year MOU with respect to their security assistance from the United States. The fact of the matter is, though, I think if you look at the map of the West Bank, if you look at the future of the two-state solution, these settlements are encroaching further and further beyond the separation barrier that the Israelis themselves built. Thousands of new settlements are being constructed. And frankly, if these trends continue, it will be impossible to realize a two-state solution. And the fact of the matter is, we can't just have a peace process or a two-state solution as an empty talking point. If we really want to be able to have a prospect for peace, we have to be clear about what we're against, and that includes the type of settlements and, I'd say, as a resolution points out, the type of incitement to violence on the Palestinian side that have been obstacles to peace.
Well, let me just read you what, among other things, the comments from Prime Minister Netanyahu after this happened. He said, the National Security Council has disgracefully ganged up on the one democracy in the Middle East. The Israeli government is saying this was a shameful resolution. They're not going to abide by it. I mean, is the president, are you comfortable with what is now a really raw opening, a sore spot in the relationship with Israel as this president leaves office?
Look, we've taken a lot of criticism from the Israeli government over the years. If you look at our record, unprecedented military intelligence cooperation, significant security assistance upgrades. But again, let's talk about what the resolution addressed. The settlement construction. That's a conversation that the Israeli government is not having. And in fact, you had this prime minister say this is the most pro-settlement Israeli government in history. Frankly, that statement is entirely inconsistent with the two-state solution that the Israeli government in the past has said they supported, that many members of Congress support. At a certain point, we all just have to stop and look at the map and look at the facts and say, if these settlements continue, is a two-state solution impossible? And that clearly is a trend line. It's evident for everybody to see. And that's what we should be talking about.
President-elect Trump, as you know, had urged the White House to veto this resolution condemning Israel. We know that he was in touch with the president of Egypt to try to intervene. Was this appropriate on his part?
Well, look, we believe that there's one president at a time. Frankly, after January 20th, the president-elect will get to pursue whatever approach he wants on this and other issues. Again, I would say it's very important. This is a bipartisan position to oppose continued settlements. And it's a bipartisan history that there have been resolutions at the UN. I keep hearing that this is unprecedented. There were six resolutions under George W. Bush that addressed the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, including one that embraced a roadmap the Bush administration put forward for a Palestinian state by 2005. That was over a decade ago. So the question is, if we are against the continued settlement activity and if we're for a two-state solution, why are we going to continue with the status quo in which we see trends on both sides, Israeli and Palestinian trends, that are putting peace further and further away?
You say it's bipartisan, but as you very well know, the leadership, Republican leadership in the Congress is raining down now with criticism. The incoming Democratic leader in the Senate, Senator Schumer from New York, is criticizing this decision. It sounds like the administration is if not alone, certainly is in the minority on this, on its position today.
Well, look, we respect, of course, friends on both sides of the aisle who've expressed different views on this. Again, I think the question is going to be when history looks at these types of decisions, when people look back and they say, you saw tens of thousands of settlements being constructed. You saw, as is addressed in that resolution, incitement to violence on the Palestinian side. The question is, do we not have a responsibility to lay down a marker here about what we think is actual U.S. policy? And if you have a resolution like this that is entirely consistent with our policy, how can we continue to veto that over and over again?
And finally, are you comfortable, is the president comfortable with this, knowing that Vice President-elect Trump is saying he's going to undo this as soon as he takes office in a few weeks? Is it worth it?
We believe it's worth it. We believe it's worth saying this is where we stand, and it's entirely consistent, again, with our policy for decades. Samantha Power, in her explanation of vote at the UN, quoted Ronald Reagan in 1982 expressing opposition to settlements. This is not a new U.S. position. And the fact of the matter is, if we're serious about achieving peace, we need to be able to stand behind the things that we believe in.
Ben Rhodes, Deputy National Security Advisor to the President. Thank you very much.
Thank you.